What's up? It's your boy DP.
It's your girl Cheri.
And welcome to a spooky edition of Grand Weekend. Going on, welcome back. Today we got a lot of things in store for you on the show, a lot of good things for you. I'm the realest gangster in the world, Ja Rule, you know, doing the thug thizzle,
and I'm the prettiest cat lady on the earth doing my thing. Today we have for you Nehemiah doing the news, and we got Thomas Jenkins doing the report, and Nehemiah's gonna take it after him and do the weather for us. So with nothing else, we're gonna kick it to Nehemiah and get this good old Ram news.
What's up, Rams? I'm Nehemiah Robinson. Wake Forest University and Winston-Salem State University athletic departments have partnership and will announce an annual event, which will be a basketball game with both of the teams. This event will take place on November the 11th, Thursday. To kick off this event, there will be a lunch in November the 4th at the Benton Convention Center. For reservations, you can call one of the numbers listed on the screen. Once again, this event will take place on Thursday, November 4th. The basketball game will take place Thursday, November 11th. Also, on November the 5th, the Winston-Salem State University Rams will take on the UNC Chapel Hill Tar Heels. Please support your teams. Tickets can be purchased at the box office. You can also go to the student activities room and also purchase tickets. Right now we're going to go to Thomas Jenkins for the 9/11 report. This film was a controversial film made by Michael Moore. It talked about Bush and his counterparts and also some other political views on war, terrorism, and other things. Also, we're going to go with Thomas Jenkins for more of that report.
Yeah, Thomas Jenkins, today for Ram Weekend at K.R. Williams Auditorium, where we'll be watching Fahrenheit 9/11.
The United States began bombing Afghanistan just 4 weeks after 9/11. Mr. Bush said he was doing so because the Taliban government of Afghanistan had been harboring bin Laden.
We'd like to know, you know, why you all feel it's important that the students came out here to see this.
We're actually just trying to promote voting. Election 2004, it's very important that we get out there and get as much education about voting. And just so we're doing as many events as we can. We got a movie tonight, Erskine Bowles tomorrow, just a lot of events. Look out for them.
I think it's important that we're educated going to the polls, that we know what we're going voting for and the different issues that are affecting us today. So,
people smoke them out of their holes.
Where do you smoke them out?
Smoke them out. Smoke them out of this case.
That's right, John. Smoke them out.
We're out here with Tiffany and Moshe, and once again, sophomore class president. We're going to ask them what they thought of the movie.
It was very informative. I think everyone should see it before they vote. It shed a lot of light on things that I wasn't clear about, and it was good.
I like the movie. I'm aware of a lot of new things now, and I'm glad I had the opportunity to see it.
All right, today, ladies and gentlemen, we had the opportunity of viewing Fahrenheit 9/11. It was very informative, quite insightful, and much can be taken from this video.
Bush really didn't do much.
But what they did was slow and small.
This is Thomas Jenkins, reporting for Ram Weekend.
And now for your weather. Today, there will be a high of 54 with a low of 55 with a 30% chance of precipitation. Excuse me. On Friday, there will be a high of 67, a low with 58 with a 20% chance of precipitation. Saturday, a high of 79 with a low of 61 with a 30% chance of precipitation. Excuse me, 20%. On Sunday, which is Halloween, there'll be a high of 76 and a low of 55 with a 30% chance of precipitation. On Monday, there'll be a high of 78 and a low of 58 with a 20% chance of precipitation. Also, remember on Saturday at 12 o'clock a.m., please set your clocks back 1 hour because daylight savings will end. And now I'm going to send it back over to Cheri and DP.
Appreciate that, Nehemiah. I can see from your weather report that it's going to be a lot of precipitation in the upcoming week. So, guys, let's please participate. Please don't go nowhere. We got a lot of things left for you on the show. We got a hot DVD review. We also got Cribs. And It's That Real. We also got The Buzz.
The Buzz. Yes. Get ready for it.
So, you know, we got these commercials. I mean, y'all know them. Y'all see them all the time. So go to it. Be right back.
I'm supposed to. You don't know what comes up before? Girl, come on.
I'm supposed to count down.
I'm good. I'm talking about war.
Yeah.
Ram TV is a campus television station that utilizes the skills and talents of the many mass comm students and other majors to come together to building quality programming, quality productions that we put out on our TV station. Right now, we are as, I think we're on the up and coming. I think we'll be at a bigger spot one day.
Ram TV gives students the opportunity to express themselves and their ideas, and it just provides us, it lets us show our creativity and display it on TV for our peers to judge and to tell us how good it is.
I was doing that.
Oh, see, you do it. You do it better.
And we're back from that great break that we just had.
New commercials, y'all.
New commercials. Y'all should be so happy.
I'm so surprised.
Yeah, coming up, we got a good DVD review. Brian and Natasha took it way back with this one, but we got New Jack City coming up. Yeah, y'all, I'm telling you, after you see this review, y'all going to want to go out and rent it and look at it again tonight. Then following that, we're probably going to enlighten you on a special topic. Ain't that right, DP?
Yes, we have some knowledge for you guys.
For you girls, too. So don't go anywhere after the DVD review, and then we're going to kick it and look at it, all right?
With all due respect, sir, I mean, you still don't get it. You're talking about a war out there that we're losing. You're not going to give me what I need to win. Now, I need some cops to know these streets. I need some New Jack cops to take down a New Jack gangster.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Halloween edition of Ram Weekend. This is Natasha.
A.K.A. Looney T.
This is Brian Foster, A.K.A. Be Scary. And we're here to do the DVD review of New Jack City. Tell me about New Jack City.
Well, New Jack City is about a drug lord who is trying to gain power in New York City. And he is being countered, you know, the police force is coming after him, and Ice-T, who plays the cop, that's right, trying to shut him down.
Shut him down.
You know, he's coming up with this big plan to get rid of Nino Brown.
Nino Brown, Wesley Snipes, and you got Pookie, who's a crackhead, named Chris Rock. But hey.
Okay, let's cut to a clip. Let's let them see what it's about, Brian.
Okay, how about we cut to a clip? Cut to a clip.
Get out! Back up! Everybody down! Police!
we're back from that great clip. What do you think about that movie?
It's okay, but I'm not one for gangster movies, and I don't think it's, you know, a very good movie for this day and age, you know, the millennium. Maybe back then it was a great movie, but now,
I mean, I liked it. Even secondhand actors, Mario, you know, had some, Judd Nelson. You don't hear about him now. Wesley Snipes, you know, Chris Rock, you know, whatever. But it had a, you know, anti-drug message.
And yeah, maybe, I do agree with the message at the end. Crack don't kills, sell drugs, cocaine, you'll get caught.
Heck of a drug. It really is. But, I mean, overall, it was a great movie. You had some special features on the DVD. What's you know that? What they are?
The soundtrack is on there. I like the soundtrack. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the soundtrack is great. Money, 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 money. Okay, it has scene access, theatrical trailer. But, okay, we just cut to the chase. How many Rams would you give this movie?
I guess I could give it 3.5 Rams.
Even though you didn't like it, okay. I give it 3.5 Rams also. I know we're supposed to have a scary movie, but sometimes reality is scary. What's going on in the community is scary.
Ooh.
But this is your Halloween edition of Ram Weekend.
Yo, my boy Nino in the house. Yo, Nino, what's up, G? Yeah.
Yo, welcome back. That's the DVD review. Brian and Tasha, a little old school for y'all, New Jack City. And you know what I'm saying? Pookie is the only dude I know that could ride a bike down a flight of stairs and go off like a 25-foot drop and get up and start running through the park.
But that's black folk for
it's,
you.
Yeah, it's crack. Rick James, Pookie, just taking over. Will Smith, Mike Tyson. Anyway, we got, you know what I'm saying, some guests in the studio for y'all today. The buzz, a little topic, you know what I'm saying, talking about gold diggers or whatever.
Yes. Today you will hear from Dana and Aaron. And Dana's going to be on my side, y'all. I'm just going to let you know, Dana's going to be on my side for all this stuff get stirred up. DP and Aaron.
Well, then I guess it is me and Aaron, since Dana and form little tag team and stuff like that. Like, mm-hmm. This is wrestling.
Women have to stick together. Isn't that right, Dana?
Well, DP, how do you feel about the gold digger situation? Being that we are on a black college campus and it does run rampant some places, how do you feel about it?
Well, you know, I feel like that. The perception is that, you know, guys are always out to get something from females and always trying to be a pimp or a player. But I mean, on the other hand, you got females that's doing just the same thing, but even worse, because, you know, they're trying to be real sneaky and conniving because they swear that they're the best cheaters and they, you know, can lie better than guys. So, you know, when you add all those elements in and they want money, you know, I just think it's a terrible combination, man.
Cheri, Dana, how y'all feel about this?
Dana, you want to get this or you want me to get it? Okay, first of all.
Gold digger aspect.
I'm going to gold digger. Yeah. And for everyone to sit here and say that every single woman on this campus is a gold digger, I envy that thought. I'm upset with that thought because.
Who said nobody said every single
woman. Well, you know what?
Nobody said every single female.
That's good. That's fun. Right.
We're not getting support from my parents, we're doing it ourselves, right?
That's it. We don't.
Aren't guys the ones that's always trying to, you know?
But this is the thing. I'm trying to tell y'all. I would like to agree with y'all. I mean, there's, you know, we go back. We got love. But
yeah,
I don't blame the females because really I feel like it's the fellas that mess it up. These bosses that, you know, spend money on these girls and give them the wrong perception.
Wait a minute. Y'all ain't going to tell me if a girl decided to pay for one of y'all bills or decided to do something, like, you ain't going to let her do it. That's a gold digger.
But guys messing up the game, just throwing money at females and shoes and all
that.
They should be pampered.
They should be pampered. But give it some time. Give it time. Don't just throw everything away.
Well, you know what? You set the pace for how you want a relationship to go. So, you know, if a woman gets everything that she wants, then it's only simply because.
That's why we're agreeing, though. We on the same page.
But no.
I'm with you.
You're saying that women always want something. But in all actuality, you know, it's only because they deserve what they
there
want.
There is fellas.
They
all
should be treated like queens.
The fellas mess it up when they come out here just trying to splurge. Because you give them the wrong perception. And then
this so-called baller type status thing where I gotta buy you a drink. We in the club.
What is that? I never buy drinks.
Buy you dinner.
We don't ask you to do that.
Exactly. You volunteer. Let me buy you a drink.
I've never don't know how y'all been. I never use that line.
Because you're looking for something in return. If
yes.
The drink.
Yes.
No, looking for something. No. Regardless. You know what I'm saying?
The drinks in the club, that's just a thing, a conversational aspect. It's sort of right. Getting, you know what I'm saying?
Whatever.
But don't y'all take know, that as expecting y'all know.
If you don't want to buy drinks, don't ask.
But y'all know y'all want drinks when y'all come in the club scratching your throat.
But at the same time.
You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to dance. You talking about.
Drinks. We don't need you to buy a drink.
How much? Asking me how much water costs? I don't know. Go find
exactly.
out.
Exactly. Don't go hard at the guy that you think has something because of a nice car and think he's going to buy you something.
Who's going to be asking? Everybody know how much water
why
costs.
Why can't we be judged about our cash?
No.
Go to the water fountain.
Exactly.
Because that's an inside, you know, that's a little hint. You know, everybody knows the price of water, but you're just trying to insinuate.
Water's supposed to be free.
Well,
water
I'm
free.
Not
go
lie.
To the water fountain.
If I go to the club, or I'm go not to the bathroom. Buying any drinks because I know somebody out there that wants to buy me
so,
a drink.
So, I mean, you wouldn't buy a guy a drink if you were actually feeling that person?
No.
See, that's the problem. See, exactly. But we're expected to buy y'all drinks.
Buy a drink.
Well, but we're expected to buy y'all drinks.
Get your hair done when the wig twisted.
No,
get your nails done. Shoes.
No.
All that.
McDonald's, Ramshack, no. All that, man. I'm cutting it out.
Don't even.
New millennium, no money for no female.
Don't
man.
Even say McDonald's or the Ramshack because that's low class to them now.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Red Lobster, Olive Garden. We got to sit down.
A girl told
me we go out on a date. That's what I want.
We got to sit down and eat. Why we got to sit down and eat? We can stand up and eat.
The menu, you got so many things you can't even
cook. Okay, they don't want to take us out.
But how many college guys you know actually know how to cook? I know I don't. I eat hot pot.
Well, you need to learn. You need to be watching Emerald.
Peanut butter and jelly all day.
Thank you. Get you through.
Come get your ham and sandwiches
ramen
and
noodles.
Cheese.
Are you kidding?
Sandwich and a sandwich. Not
but I mean, if a man really loves you, and he fixed you a banging ham sandwich with a salad or something. You trying to tell me you couldn't accept that?
That's fine.
I would.
With some Kool-Aid. And ice
exactly. Red at that.
Kool-Aid. And
ice we're not gonna have that every weekend.
Exactly.
You're gonna take me out sometime.
If the dude's pockets are not financially straight to be able to take
if
you to
you got
Olive
on a fresh pair of Air Force Ones every time I see you, you got some
Air Force Ones. That has nothing to do.
Air Force Ones
are status.
Exactly.
You don't need 10 pairs.
That is an investment into a male's appearance. Air Force Ones. A meal. I mean, a meal. Is a meal.
If you know you eat more than ham sandwiches a day and you just gonna give me a ham
but that's
sandwich,
me, but
Air Force Ones is to make sure that we can actually get a female to
exactly.
Come approach us because the
without
first thing
the
females
Ones,
be like, if you, can't take care, if you can't take
not.
Care of your shoes,
exactly.
Then you can't take care of yourself. So we got the nice Air Force Ones, but I mean, dang, I'd rather have a pair of Air Force Ones than to take a girl out to eat
okay.
Every
any
single
day
of the week.
That's gonna come
oh,
in
you know
good
what?
Gracious.
Okay. We're going to have to continue this
yeah.
Another time.
Yeah,
because right
they
now.
Know who's right. Golden.
No, you're not.
Hey, stop
you're
messing
not.
Up the game, spending money on these bras.
Please stop doing it,
oh, why we got
to
be bras?
I don't have to do it, man. Y'all don't need to buy them everything.
I eat a ham sandwich.
Eat a ham sandwich.
I eat a ham sandwich.
Ham sandwich. I'm going to eat a spam sandwich. All right.
Thank you.
We're going
to hit it off with Chris, with Brian, Johannes.
Yeah.
So stay tuned. We got some more shoe lickers for you.
What? Yeah, you a gold digger. Shoe licker.
What?
Penny snatch, get your hands out my pockets. Penny snatch, get your hands out my pockets.
I got them.
Welcome, Ram TV 19, to this segment of Cribs. I'm your host, Brahan Johannes, and this is the Cribs segment. We're in Rams Commons, Building 12. You know, it's nothing. I was, you know what I'm saying, people seen my room and they was like, yo, my room cleaner than yours. My room better than yours. I'm trying to get on Cribs. I was like, word? It's nothing, you know what I'm saying? So we had been, what is it, been in four, room 12? Better knock on the door, you know what I'm saying? They know I'm coming, so. It's good.
Good,
fam. Ram TV 19?
What up, man?
What's your name?
James, man.
All right, we got 10. Where you from, James?
I'm from New York, man.
All right, okay. All right, this is your room right here? This is your house?
Yeah, man. This is my room right here. I share it with my cousin over there.
What they playing over here? What you got over here?
It's a little 007 over here. Nintendo people before we go to back old school. So this is what we do, man.
All right, you got a PlayStation? What you got? I know you ain't got Madden. Let me see what you...
Oh, man, we got the NBA Live 2004.
Can you beat me in this?
Yeah. Are
you serious? Let's go! Hey, when the cameras come on, can we see your room? Where your room at? Are you serious? Is this how we do? I mean, if you're a baller, you can have 28 pairs of white tees. I mean, it's nothing.
I mean, this is really nothing right here, man. I'll just pull out something for you. This is the Jordan jersey right here.
Throwback.
45 when you used to play for Chicago White Sox.
Throwback. Classic.
Johnny Cash.
Woo!
Philadelphia. Oh, man, it's another White Sox jersey my man Fab had on in the video. You won't find this in stores. It's like $700.
How you get it, yeah?
Come on, I got connects for days. Keep going. Camilla Anderson.
All right, that's enough. That's enough. As you can see, I mean, if you're a baller.
I mean, this shit keep going.
If you're a baller, then you got... Ooh!
Oak Hill, Camilla Anthony, too.
All right, enough with the closet, man. We can't eat. Because I can't live like that. So, you know what I'm saying? We just going to move to something else that I can...
You're missing that brown fitted...
Smell good section.
Oh, man. Fellas, y'all need to get this, man. It's Versace Dreamer right here, man. It's $80 bottle right here. You put this on your neck, walk by a chick, she's bound to compliment you on that. Off gate, man.
So, I mean, that's nothing if you can afford something like this. It's nothing. You just bought it. You know what I mean? All right, we're going to check it out. What we got? 28-inch speakers?
Nah, man. It's little 13s. 13-inch speakers. Little system. Get it knocked on the chicks.
Nah, we don't even want to hear all that. We don't even want to hear all that.
It's on the other side of my closet or whatever, man. More jackets. Got the Timberlands all lined up there. I know y'all ain't seen these yet, man. These artists, man. I seen the other kid on Ram TV up here licking it. Come on, man. This is what we do, man.
It's nothing. It's just...
You know what I'm saying? This is what we do. I got another fresh pair, too. Lick that all day, man. This is what I do.
So I hope you ain't wear that.
Nah, man, I ain't wear these yet, man. I'm just waiting for a special time to put these on.
This is the studio right here. Okay. So you all rap? What?
Nah, not really. Just for fun. We just chilling, yo. We just be in the James and Max in the room chilling, having some fun. You know, that's how we do.
It's my man Lloyd Banks right here, man.
Hey, I'm gonna let y'all know like this. This kid right here, he cooler than the other side of the pillow. I mean, it's nothing. Sometimes when you sleep, you gotta flip it over. That's him. He just
this
cool.
This dude got the Kanye West chain on. The Kanye West.
Yeah, I got
look
it.
At this. Look at all the ice.
Okay, we done checked out the studio. We done checked out James' room. We done checked out Max's room. I guess it's time for us to leave, man. I know when we're not wanted anymore. It's time for us to leave. You ready? Thanks for tuning in, Ram TV 19. That was the crib for this week's Cribs. As always, tune in next week. We'll have more cars, more cribs. It's nothing, you know what I'm saying? But if you got a crib that you want to show off, holla at me. I mean, it's nothing. I'm here for days. It's nothing. I'm here for. You know what I'm saying? Holla at me. Cribs all day. Thanks for tuning in to this segment of Ram Weekend. I'm your host, Brian Johannes.
Welcome back, guys. Few comments about my man crib or whatever. Number one, shoe licking is not, I don't know if that's like a little trend thing, but I mean, come on, guys, licking shoes, let's leave it alone. Number two, $700 for a jersey.
I think you need to do away with that one because everybody on campus is going to see that. Someone's going to break into your room. I will go ahead and lock that one up.
Right, because clearly he didn't pay $700.
Exactly.
I don't know who his connect is. Joe Blow the Smoke, but he didn't pay $700 for that jersey. I promise you, probably paid $17 and got a Tic Tac. You know what I'm saying? Because he didn't pay nobody $700. If you pay $700, do not enroll in state next
Please
semester.
Don't.
Leave.
Please.
Go somewhere else. $700?
Yes.
Ooh, that jersey better talk, cook, clean, fish, jump rope, checkers, shoots and ladders.
That's like 2 months of payment at Rams Commons, ain't it? Yeah.
No, that's probably like 1 month of payment. It's a fine.
I forgot.
Rams is high.
Yes.
Ram Prime. Mm.
But anyway.
And my last comment, is it just me or does that guy with the throwback Winston-Salem jersey, is he in like every single crib segment that we do?
I've seen him before. He's trying to be the host or something. I don't know.
I don't know because I know I've seen him before. I swear we went to his crib.
He started the shoe licking. He did a shoe licking cat.
Yeah, he's the one. Matter of fact, he's the one that started the shoe licking.
Just licking shoes for no reason.
And now it's a coincidence that he's in this week. It's like back to back. Trying to be like Rick James. You can't do it.
I know. But you know what? Y'all stay tuned. We got It's That Real with Thomas Jenkins coming up and we're going to go pay some bills. So just stay tuned and sit tight.
I'm supposed to get on your cousin's floor. Girl, come on.
That's
how
they count down.
I'm good. I'm
talking
about war.
Yeah. Ram TV is a campus television station that utilizes the skills and talents of the many mass comm students and other majors to come together to building quality programming, quality productions that we put out on our TV station. Right now, we are I think we're on the up and coming. I think we'll be at a bigger spot one day.
Ram TV gives students opportunity to express themselves and their ideas, and it just provides us, it lets us show our creativity and display it on TV for our peers to judge and to tell us how good it is.
I was doing that.
Oh, where you going? Yeah, you do it. You do it. You do it better.
Huh?
All right, guys, and yeah. We're back. We got something really good for you. We switched it up this week.
Murder, Inc.